Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Connected Kids. This is Connected Kids Children's Church for Connected Church. Good morning, Daniel Joseph.
Good morning, Daddy.
Good morning, Ariella Christina.
Good morning, Dad.
Happy Sunday, everyone. We are so grateful that you are here and joining us once again for our Children's Church. My name is Charles Botts. I'm the founder here at Connected Church, and I am joined by, alongside with my lovely children, Daniel Joseph. Wave and say good morning.
Good morning.
Ariella, wave and say good morning.
Hello.
Yes, I love that. Yes, the wave, the princess wave. That's wonderful. It is time to kick off our service, and we usually have Daniel start us off with prayer. Ariella, do you feel inspired to start us off with prayer this morning?
I don't like to can.
But I think maybe it would be nice for you to do it this Sunday, because Daniel's done it for like the last 3 weeks. What do you say?
Okay, on the third week.
And I think you did it the week before then.
No.
Okay. Daniel, would you like to open us up with prayer?
Yeah, because last week I did.
Oh, no, she didn't do it last week, but you can still open us up with prayer.
Lord, we thank you for this wonderful day, and that we can all have a safe Sunday morning today, and we have a fun time doing children's church, and everybody has a fun morning. And everybody has their best time today. And everybody knows that God's always with us. And God should always be with us. And we believe in God. And if we believe in God one day, we'll say one for you. And I believe that we die on the cross for our sins. We're going up in heaven with him someday. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Wonderful, wonderful prayer. So with that, we are going to go straight into our worship service. Ariella has picked our song for this morning. I'm not going to share my screen. That hasn't been working very well. So we are going to turn the camera to our TV so that we give appropriate honor to Mr. Toby Mack, who will be singing as part of our worship, Me Without You. Praise him, Ella. That's me without you, ooh, 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 ooh. If you're grooving with us, get up, stand up, feel that spirit going through. Had me, I believe it. Where would I be? I'll be kicking everything that goes my way. I'll be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you. Without you. Ella, why are you getting nervous? It's okay to praise the Lord, have fun praising the Lord. It's time for the dad moves, dad moves, dad moves, dad moves. All right, enough dad moves. Make me, make me, me. I'll be back in my fast. I'll be kissing every dream that comes my way. I'll be making my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, let me be back in my back. I'll be kissing every dream that comes my way. That's me without you. Oh, what's me without you? Without you.
Daddy,
huh? All right. Good stuff. Me Without You by Mr. Toby Mac, formerly of DC Talk. Yes, give it up for 80s gospel rap. Big time. DC Talk in the building. So, Me Without You. Okay, excellent. Very excited for today's lesson. So let's get into it. Let's jump into today's lesson, which is an interesting one. Today's lesson is interesting because it's about a story that Jesus told to his followers about being ready. Being ready and how important it is to be ready. So, to help us understand this, I want you guys to imagine that you are getting ready to go to Disney World! Yeah! Could you imagine how cool that would be if we were getting ready to go to Disney World? Okay, so, Daniel, I'll start with you first. If you had to get ready because you knew that your family was going to Disney World, what's one of the things you would have to do to get ready?
I would pack my suitcase.
You would pack your suitcase. What sort of things would you pack in your suitcase?
I'd pack my stuffies. Uh-huh. I'd pack my toys. I'd pack my tablet.
Uh-huh.
I'd pack the Switch.
Okay.
I'd pack some games.
Okay.
And I'll pack some things for the parents.
Oh, well, that was very wonderful that you're thinking about your parents. Ariella, what do you think about Daniel's packing? Has he really prepared himself to go to Disney World?
He prepared himself halfway.
Okay. What sort of things is he missing?
You also need a bathing suit.
Oh, yeah, I also got that.
You also need sunglasses.
I've packed that.
Oh, okay. So
sunscreen.
Okay.
And
yes.
You need to rent a hotel.
Parents would kind of take care of that kind of stuff. But the things that you would need, that you guys would need to be ready. So
and
what I've heard.
Need to be ready?
Yes. What do you think you would need to be ready to go to Disney World, Ella?
My tablet. My stuffies.
Mm-hmm.
That's technically packing your suitcase. That's really important.
My dolls.
Mm-hmm.
A small.
Oh, and I also got my dolls.
A small house for my dolls.
Mm-hmm.
And some DVDs so that we can watch DVDs for.
Oh, so some DVDs. Okay, so this is what I've heard.
In order for you guys to
be ready for Disney World, you need toys, stuffies, tablets, DVDs, the Switch, sunscreen, sunglasses, and a bathing suit. And that's all you need to be ready for Disney World.
Yeah. That's all the kids need.
So you don't use any other things other than that?
Right, bed clothes.
Oh yeah, and bed clothes.
Well, how about regular clothes?
And church clothes.
And how about toothbrush?
And a toothbrush.
Right. So we need like all of those types of things to be ready
and a table
to go somewhere. So Jesus was teaching a lesson about being ready. But what was interesting about this particular lesson is that he was teaching a lesson about when he would come back. Now, did you guys know that Jesus is supposed to come back to the earth?
Yes.
Did you guys know that?
Yeah, because he takes everyone
Yeah, that's right, Ella. Everyone that's alive at the time that he comes back is supposed to go to his Father's new heaven and new earth, part of the eternal kingdom.
It's technically everybody that believes in God.
Yes, yes,
but
thank you.
But they have to be alive.
Yes, to go up with Jesus when he comes back, but everyone that believes in God that maybe passed away would still get to go to heaven.
Probably won't be me.
As well. Well, we don't know. So, and that, Ariella, that is a perfect segue. Do you guys know what a segue is?
No.
A segue is like a... Oh, do you know what a segue is, Ella?
I know what a segment is, but I don't know what a segue is. So a segue
is like a transition. It's like when you move from one topic of conversation or one idea to another. So, Ariella, you said something that was very interesting. You said that you're not sure. You said you probably wouldn't be alive when Jesus comes back.
Because I'm 3 years older than him and I'm actually a teenager.
Right, but we don't know when Jesus is coming back.
I'm pretty sure.
Jesus tells us a story about being ready. And so we're going to read from, in our Bibles, we're going to read Matthew chapter 25. And I will actually try to share my screen on this one so that our friends and family can follow along. You don't need to get your Bibles because you don't have this story in your Bibles. So let me zoom in a little bit here, make it a little bit easier to read for folks that are watching. Okay, so this is the story of the 10 virgins. It starts with Matthew chapter 25.
What are virgins?
That's a great question. We're going to answer that in just a second. That is a great question. Yes, sorry, Daniel.
What does Ella said mean?
Yes, well, you just heard me answer Ariella. At the time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. So you had 10 virgins, 10 young women. They haven't been married yet. 5 are smart and 5 are silly. The wise ones, the 5 smart ladies, however, took oil in their jars along with their lamps.
Is that lamps or
lamps? Lamps. Lamps, like where you have a light.
Yeah, like a light in my room, a dino light.
Mm-hmm. Yes. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, the cry rang out, "Here's the bridegroom! Come out to meet him!" Then all the young ladies, all the virgins, woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the smart ones, "Give us some of your oil. Our lamps have gone out. We don't have a light." The smart ones said, "Nope, there may not be enough for both of us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. So, yes, Ariella, what is your question?
What are bridegrooms?
The bridegroom is the man that's about to get married.
And Daddy, I have a question.
He's also called the groom, yes.
My question is, was the door locked so nobody else could get in?
Or yes.
Was it locked?
Yes. It's a very good question, Daniel. So in this story, guys, this is really important. In this story, there was a tradition at in the old days in Israel where if there was going to be a Jewish wedding, people would come out and they would light lamps to lead the new husband and the new wife to the wedding banquet. And so it was a great honor to stand on the road and guide the couple into the wedding. And so if you were a part of that, of guiding them in, you got to go into the wedding with them and participate in all the festivities. But if you weren't, you got left out. So what happened in this situation? I'll get right with you, Ella, 1 second. In this situation, there were 10 young ladies that wanted to go to the wedding. They wanted to be part of the festivities and have a good time. 5 of them were smart and 5 of them were silly. What made the smart young ladies smart? What did they do that was smart, Ariella?
They prepared and they got oil so that way their lamps wouldn't run out.
Yes, Daniel.
That was what I was going to say.
Okay.
And I was also going to say.
Yeah. I didn't finish.
What I was going to say.
Okay, Ariella didn't finish.
The silly ones, the reason why they were silly, because they didn't prepare. They didn't get oil.
That's correct. Yes, Daniel.
Ella said everything that I was going to say.
Okay, you can answer the next question. No problem. So, yes. The smart ones were smart because they were prepared. Because when they were getting ready to go to Disney World, in our example, they didn't just bring toys. That would be silly to go to Disney World and only pack a Switch and a tablet and stuffies and dolls with no clothes and no toothpaste and no underwear. That would be silly. That would be foolish.
I was about to say, but until you interrupted, also, underwear, toothbrush, a table, church stuff, clothes, morning clothes, underwear.
Got it. Okay, Ariel, if you could sit up, please. So the point of Jesus' story was to tell his followers, you have to be ready because you don't know when I'm coming back. So for you and I today, we don't have lamps that need oil. There are other things we do to be prepared. So what are some things that a Christian does to be prepared? Daniel, sit up, please.
What they do to be prepared. Something that I would do as a Christian to be prepared is I think, if I'm going to heaven, what will I need? And then I'll think of what I need and get everything I need.
Mm-hmm. Ella, what are some things Christians can do to be prepared for when Jesus comes back?
What they can do is they could get ready by doing church things.
Like? What's an example of a church thing?
Watching church shows.
Okay.
Playing church games.
Okay.
Daniel,
you said something a couple minutes ago that was very important about the people that would go to heaven with Jesus. What did you say? They had to, you used a B word. They had to
be prepared.
Yes, they have to be prepared. Ella, please sit in your chair. Yes, they have to
be ready.
They have to be ready, but you used something else. You said they have to blank in God. They have
believe
to
in God.
Believe in God. Yeah. And this is so important, guys, is if we're going to be ready for when Jesus comes back, we have to believe in God. And by believing in God, we do certain things. If we believe in God, do you think we pray?
Pray.
Yeah. If we believe in God, do you think we read our Bible?
Yes.
If we believe in God, do you think we worship
yes.
God? Are those things that we could do to be yes. ready for when Jesus comes back?
Yes.
Now, if we believe in God, but we don't do any of those things, is that really being ready?
No, but it is when I believe in God, just
really. Well, so that's a good question. That's a good point, Ariella. So, do you believe that mommy is your mommy?
Yes.
Yeah.
Would you disrespect her?
No.
Would you ignore what she says?
I mean, I do that sometimes.
But on purpose or by accident?
By accident.
And then what do you do when you find out that you...
I say sorry.
We go on timeout and then we say sorry.
You apologize, yeah.
Yeah, but
so, if you believe that mommy is your mommy... You show her respect, you listen to what she says, you don't ignore her, you don't act like she's not in the house. So if we believe in God, to your point, Ariella, maybe we don't do those things all the time, but should we be doing something to...
I know.
We can do them, but we could make time for oral stuff, but we have to make time for... the other things too.
Yeah, of course. If we believe in God, then we need to act like God exists. And we need to do things that demonstrate that we believe God exists. Yes, Daniel.
What I was going to say is that we need to worship Him, sing mm-hmm. songs to Him, praise Him, read the Bible, do it as He says, listen to our parents, do as what our parents say.
Those are all wonderful things, Daniel.
Obey your parents and never lie to your parents.
I agree. So let's get ready for our craft. All right, so we're going to move into the craft portion of today's lesson. And so we are going to make mini lamps like the 10 young ladies have. And so you're going to need a cup, pipe cleaner or ribbon. This fashions a holder for your cup that becomes your lamp. So we've got some pipe cleaner, popsicle stick, some markers, of course, your construction paper, and some scissors. And so what you're going to do is... take the popsicle stick and you're going to end up gluing or taping the popsicle stick to the inside of the cup, and it will end up looking something like this. Let me share my screen so you can see what we're looking like. This is what your final product will look like right here. And again, as you can see, sundayschool.works is where we get a lot of our lessons from. So this is what Daniel and Ariella are going to be working on. So we will be working on this, and then we will come back in just a moment to wrap up for the day. Okay. All right. So we finished up our crafts. As you can see, we have our lamps. Because your paper is going down onto the bottom. So these are our lamps. They say, be ready when He comes. So as we wrap up this morning, and hopefully once again, you all have been blessed by Connected Kids, I think it is very important to remember, as Daniel shared with us, the number one thing is believing in God. And then Ariella reminded us that if we believe in God, we need to be ready. There are things that we need to do to prepare for when Jesus comes back for us, when Jesus comes back to the earth to bring with Him all of the believers. And there are some things that we can do to continue to demonstrate our belief, not only to God, but our belief to God, we can demonstrate it to others through things like worship and prayer and praise
and
reading the Bible. And Daniel, you said something else too. You said listening to... listening to your parents, yeah, obeying
and not lying,
and not lying, and obeying those individuals that are in authority. So hopefully everyone is encouraged and blessed. Thank you once again for joining us for Connected Church. As we go out, remember to stay
stay healthy and stay in the fight.
Absolutely. God bless, guys. Take care. Thanks again. Bye, everyone. Bye.